evening. So the today's lecture will be by architect Dhammika Chandrasekara. The title is insulated building types of the Kandyan period, the monks residences and the houses on stone pillars in Kurunegala district. Architect Dhammika Chandrasekara is a chartered architect. He received his BSc and MSc in architecture from University of Moradua and is currently a senior lecturer at the Faculty of Architecture, University of Moradua. He was a former head of the Department of Architecture and the coordinator of the postgraduate course on architectural conservation of monuments and sites, conducted by the same department. He has carried out a number of research and documentation projects covering Sri Lanka's traditional architecture, particularly on historic ambalamas and temple viharas scattered in different parts of the island. He has published several books, and among them are The Fortifications Along the Kalani River, and has co-authored Heritage Buildings of Sri Lanka, Ambalava Buildings of Sri Lanka, and Architecture of Tampita Vihara Buildings. Architect Chandrasekara is a council member of ICOMOS Sri Lanka and also a trustee of the National Trust of Sri Lanka. I invite Architect Chandrasekara to be here.
Thank you very much, Dr. Nilan, for that kind introduction. Building types of Kandyan period, the monk residences and image houses on stone pillars at located at Kurunegala district. That's the topic. As the topic explains, it is not the typical monk residences or the image houses on stone pillars, which is better known as temple viharas. It's a different type or a exceptional type where the inner wall is insulated by an external wall. So actually you get two walls. Now these buildings belong to Sri Lankan vernacular architectural tradition, and the examples mainly belong to Kandyan period, 15th century to 19th century. And most of the scholars try to explain vernacular, Sri Lankan vernacular architecture, or in that case vernacular architecture in any part of the world, as a response or a solution to climate, local technology, locally available material, socio-cultural context of the local area. So it's more local rather than located at the center. Grand architecture is opposite of that. And we understand the difference between the grand architecture, that's a city, palaces, large temples designed by professionals trained in that aspect, whereas the folk tradition is like the village in a house. If villagers construct their houses by themselves or small devis, the vernacular tradition is slightly bit improved version of the folk tradition, adapted lots of features, technology from the folk tradition, maybe some example from grand tradition influence. But in a way it's between the folk and the grand tradition, but more related to folk tradition. So Avas is monk residences of the Kandyan periods belongs to this tradition, and the Dhammika Viharas or the image houses on stone pillars is another classical example for the vernacular architecture of Sri Lanka. I will first try to explain the typical type of the Avas and then the special type, then similar way the typical Dhammika Viharas and the special type of Dhammika Viharas. Now the typical monk residence or the Avasa as a central courtyard of the Kandyan period. You have central courtyard and the monks' sleeping quarters. So the rooms are located facing the courtyard, those open into that. You have a front veranda where the monks will meet the lay people of the village. But the courtyard and the area around is more private, and on the rear you will have a refectory or a dhanasala and a door so that villagers can bring meals, dana from the rear door. That's for service area, and sometimes you get small courtyards, but they are service courtyards. And the good example, probably the best example, is the Dalukkula temple on Kalathuwe Road in Kandy, well preserved. But the Lanka temple, well known, the temple, it also has interesting central courtyard type towers, unfortunately modified. Sakuma temple, interior of Kandy, has this kind of courtyard towers again. Kalawa temple again, north of Kandy, smaller towers again. The Gavilipitiya, that is Murangammana, we have a fairly special type, not the type that I am going to discuss, the central courtyard towers again, which has a campina section in the front. Then also at Gadladinian you have a campina, sorry, you have a central courtyard towers again. I am going to show some of the pictures. Now this is Dalukkula temple. Unfortunately, this is a recent addition, the balusters, otherwise it's a long, I think this is slightly distorted. It's elongated, this picture. Is it a problem with the?
Yeah,
problem with this. Yes, slightly elongated. This is the plan, and you can see the central courtyard. This is the front area where the monks will meet the lay people, and two doors. And this is a private living area for monks, looking into this open courtyard. Then these are the bedrooms or the sleeping quarters of the monks. And then towards the rear, you have a courtyard and the refectory, storehouses, and a service and a door to enter the service area, kitchen, etc. So that's basically the typical layout of a Awas again. That's a section where you have the central court, the veranda or the walkway around the bedrooms. The bedrooms generally have a small windows opening outwards, and single monk will occupy one room. So you have rooms on either side. This is a long section. The front veranda, the living area of the monks, the courtyard, these are the doors to the bedrooms, living areas, service courtyard, kitchen, refectory, in the rear. This is the picture. This is a very nice face of the courtyard. You can see there some colonial influences in the arch openings and all. But space-wise, well lit, very habitable, nice space, rooms opening and monks sitting areas around it. So this is one of the best examples of central courtyard type power is of the Kandyan period. This Lanka temple, again you can see the central court, rooms, front veranda, and then the rear court, the rear service areas. Unfortunately, this is modified now. This is how it was earlier. One of the official drawings done earlier. The atugays in the front. Who atugays? The Lankavika temple, inner court, the rooms. Gandhari temple, similar arrangement. You don't have columns on the edge, but one has worked under the EU, slightly squarish old yard. Sagama temple, you have a central court, front veranda, rooms, and the rear two courtyards and an access from the main area and the refectory and the dining areas. Sagama temple section, so this is the main courtyard and the service courtyard. Cross section and the front elevation of Sagama. This is the Avasagi at the video of Arana and the Arana, Yavipi Mahal and Arnaika. You can see the front section on stone boulders, stone pillars really. Again, central courtyard, front veranda, rooms. You don't have rooms on either side in this place. Section at the video. You can see the central courtyard, the front veranda which is on campiter, side view. Now we come to the special type. So this is the pond type of the Kandyan period. We can find a different or an exceptional example, and I am going to show four of them, and all of them are located around Naramala, Giriulla, Naramala in Kurunegala district. They don't have a courtyard. Now this, one of the best examples of this type, though the building is in dilapidated condition, the monk is not occupying this, they have constructed another building down. This is a rock boulder, so the building is on the natural rock itself. It's a hip roof building. This is closer to Karagahagindra Ambalam, because many people visit that. And you can see the plan. What you see is two rooms inside, which are used as sleeping quarters or store rooms of the monks. And then if you take out these three walls, you will see a veranda space around and another wall. So actually these two rooms do not have windows opening to external service. Like today, if you look at the regulations and all, these will be rejected. When UDA will reject the outside, because they don't open, they don't have proper light and ventilation. But if you go in, they are very comfortable. Thick walls and half round tiles, so that you get some kind of air movement. But this area, so the front area is like a veranda. This area, because you have a door here, so could be used, probably would have been used as a refectory, and these as other storage and dining spaces. So typical plan is you have rooms in the inner layer, veranda going around it. Instead of columns, you have a solid wall like that. You have a solid wall, so the inner rooms are insulated from the external surface completely. Now this is Vihalgura temple, again fairly well known temple because it has this very significant image houses and the relic chamber house on the top of the summit. This is located at the lower level. Again same type, slightly different. The roof, you have this opening between the side gable end. This part is hip, so you get some kind of ventilation. Again, the building is not maintained. Again, like recently I went there and Ankh has constructed new Avas again. If you look at the plan, it's like that. You can see the inner core, these two rooms, maybe this room. You enter from here, and on the side, you will have refectories, and again, and circulation part or a veranda, not really veranda space, the space around which is again protected by an external wall, small windows. Section of Biharpura temple, some it's where the name as Biharpura is mentioned because that's also name used for this building, this temple. Elevation, so you will see this opening. This is the main door and side door, windows, but the inner rooms are. This is Mathepola at Giriulla, about 1 kilometer away from Giriulla. This place is again well known because it has a very important cave temple, image house, and Sorius Mendes, who drew the paintings at Kalyani, was doing paintings here, and Madame Vijayavardhana, they had land in that area, so him working, doing paintings, and as a consequence, he was sent to India, came back and did the Kalyani temples, and also finished part of the Erula temple after returning from India. And you will see distinctly different two styles in the cave image house before going to India, paintings done by Sorius Mendes, and paintings done by him after coming back from India. But this is the image, the Navasa cave. It's in a sloping land, so there's slight what if changes to the design. But if you look at it, again it has two rooms, a space around it, and this is at the lower level, and a door, a small veranda in front, but this is the living area, and a rear entry. So you will have the basic concept of having inner rooms and a space around it. This is Anmoru again of Aramala. Something similar to the image house at Biharpura. So you have this side opening between the two hoops. Again, they have constructed a new image avasa here. So we see this distinctly different style. There you have the inner rooms insulated by this about 10 feet, 12 feet wide space, which is used as living, dining. Maybe sometimes you will see a bed there because the monks would use that space also as sleeping space. So it's a multi-purpose space, living, dining, refectory, all those activities happen in different parts of the outer space, and the inner rooms are basically sleeping quarters or storage spaces where they keep their valuables. Then we come to Dhammika Viharas. A typical Dhammika Vihara or common design is you have an inner cell and a walkway around with the handrail on the periphery. Sometimes you will have small Dhammika Viharas where you have only the inner cell, no veranda space around. So that's a typical, which is found mainly in Kebol district, but also in many other districts, like starting from Ammantota, you have a few, four, five, Mathare, you have a few, Kebol district, you have one, Palutara, you have one, Kampaha, you have about eight, I think pretty close to one's area, you have several of them, Varapalan and several other Dhammika Viharas. Most of the Dhammika Viharas are located in Kebol district, some in Ratnapura, then Kandy, quite number, Mathale, I have not come across a single in Morelia, though there are few Dhammika Devalas in Morelia and Badulla, Kurunegala one, at least for one or two, Anuradhapura few, about 5-6. Of view. So you get this design in most parts of the island, and if you look at this, not very close to Colombo in the Kampala district, Okay, I'm there. So it's a typical layout where you have veranda or a walkway and the inner cell. Put the statue in the imposture columns. Section of that, you can see the veranda and the number one in Kurunegala district is a single cell, small one, but it's very significant temporary area because of the paintings in the building. It doesn't have a walkway around. Single cell. This is in Gampa town, actually, in Yaramita. Again, you will see. I must also mention that most of these drawings were done by first year students at the Department of Architecture. Museum Motto every year. They do set of measure drawings. And these Avasakis drawings that I have shown, Avasakis as well as the MPTV others, were done as part of the academic exercise. Again, you will see instead of a timber handrail, varichi wall about 3 feet high, and the inner cell. Section of the same building. This in Kurunegala district. You don't have a handrail, but a walkway around it. And renovated, the roof is renovated by Archaeological Department, I expect, which was taken about 10 years ago. Being India, the biggest Kandyan Vihara, the ground floor is used as a pre-king gathering multiple space. The image house is in the upper floor. Ulugaha Weber of Mahava, between Mahava and Nikavara here, one of the best examples of Sri Lankan molecular architecture. You see a lower roof and this veranda space around it. The tank is behind this Ulugaha Weber. This is between like Mahava and Nikavara here, connecting road, slightly interior in Kurunegala district. This is the section of this temple, which has this lower roof. This is an interesting example. This is the only temple we have in Gold district. This was measured about 10 years, not 10 years, I mean 15 years before by the students. What you can see is, these are concrete, and the monk in charge of the temple, with all the good intentions, has seen the timber beams decaying. So what he has done with his knowledge to protect the building, he has replaced them with concrete. So you have concrete walls, timber floor. This is only the example preserved in Gold district. Kadigamo, this is for Prabhupana. Kadigamo is the next rail station towards Kandy. This is the only temple which has two temple viharas, which is mentioned by C.P. Bell in detail in his K. Gold report book. Actually, he mentioned three image houses of Kadigamo temple, criticizing the third, which was constructed lately, about 20 years before, in visiting the temple in 1890s. Then the lower level amphitheater vihara, you can see the upper level amphitheater vihara behind, that is this, but you get a stupa in front of it. But again, a typical layer plan where you have a walkway around with a handrail. Upper level, you will see a stupa house in front, Ulage, the amphitheater vihara, which was constructed about, I think, 100 years after the first one. So you get two capitales there. Now the Dhammika Viharas, the double wall type, which is the exception, there is a second wall on the periphery instead of a handrail. So you get two walls, for the inner cell you get a chamber, instead of the handrail on the edge, you get another solid wall. However, in Kurunegala district, you can see the outer wall, small windows, about 15 inches by 15 inches, but again it's in a rocky site. You can see the plan. You enter into the front veranda space and the walkway, small windows with light and the important inner cell for the inner chamber. Then the statue, the main statue, standing figures of Lord Buddha, figures of God, Vishnu and Brahma generally on either side. Sapugas Kanda temple, this is at Vadakada between Narangala and Kolgahavila, connecting Bodo, between Potuhara and Narangala in a hillock. Nice temple is located, and you get this outer wall and the inner cell. Bihar Polar, the one that I showed you on the summit, you get another Kandyan Vihara. It also has rooms inside with solid walls of paper. Kondruapur again in Kurunegala district, you get similar type of Kandyan Vihara. Mahamitava, this is in Anamalu electorate of Nikavaratiya Putlam Road. Similar layout, solid walls, entry, and the inner. Mahamitava, you can see the perspective drawing. Section. Baladuragenya Vario Polar. Slightly taller the ground floor. But you can see the small windows, staircase to go up, and the outer wall. Balador is the layout, the lower level roof. Now, most of the examples that I showed you, the double wall type, all the four Avasagis, Vihalpola, Madhyapola, Annoruva, and Tarakavila, they are located, except Madhyapola, the other three are located about 3 km radius from Narangala town, or 4 km radius from Narangala town. Madhyapola is of Giriulla, but in that area between like Narangala and Giriulla. Except Mahamitava and Baladora, other Dhammika Viharas are in Puliyapitiya Narangala area, Tamadini electorate, or in Puliyapitiya electorate. But Mahamitava and Baladora are also located in dry areas of the Kurunegala district. So, can we explain now? Can we explain this double wall system as a response to climbing? because we know in hot climates, hot dry climates, even in other parts of the world, you get very buildings which will have few windows, solid walls, they don't have a lot of openings. Instead, the walls are very solid, then the interior does not get the temperature outside. And also, as I showed you, it's like Karakaha Ketra, the Avasaji is located on a stone boulder, so the reflective heat will increase the temperature, but if you go there during daytime, it's comfortable because it's very, very insulated. Similar thing also about Tampita Viharas, because when you get the heat, reflected heat, it could damage the sometimes we see paintings, especially on the outer walls, not interior paintings. They try to paint a papaya on the outer wall, or to create more thermally comfortable space. They have introduced this double wall system. Because in humid climates, we know we need more ventilation and courtyard works in that kind of situation, because in places like Kalambo, in Kandy or Ranthambore, if you keep a building closed, you will see fungus growth on the floor for 2-3 days if you close a building and it doesn't have windows. So one can try to explain this as a response to climate, but drier climates in that area compared to Kandy, K-Gold, because you don't get this kind of avasagis in other parts of the country. They are basically in Kandy, K-Gold. They are mainly the traditional vernacular architecture. The buildings of avasagis are of central courtyard. But very recently, actually this year, when we tried to measure drawings, I found some examples, at least two examples, in Hathraliyad area, which is not dry, hot climatic area, which is the climate is more connected or related to the climate of Kandy. Actually, it's in Kandy district, so slightly low elevation. Two Dhammika Chandrasekaras, which very many people will not visit because the roads are very bad during past, but now I understand these roads are very good between Galagadra to Mount Kanan. Vidigamo temple is located near near Galagadra. It also has a double walled image house with two side entrances. Just that is Kandyan temple, Kalagadra. That's the perspective. You have a front running hall and the Dhammika Vihara in the rear. But again, it has this typical double wall arrangement. Then the second one is located at Archt. So this is Archt Valigodapura. Again, similar layout. You can see the running hall. It probably would have been used as preaching hall also. We have seats. They are used as chair for preaching. But the inner chamber, the drawing plan of the image house at Hathraliyad. So probably, and also we need more investigation about this type, because we can see some other examples, and I was told that there is at least one Avas again, which also not exactly double wall type Avas again, but something similar in Hathraliyad area, slightly interior. they have not visited there. We also know some of these temples in Hathariyadde area were connected to where it is Sarnakrit area. That is earth area, and you have some temples named after him. And also we know places like Vatthepola was visited by Sarnakrit Thero. That's one connection, but it doesn't give us any clue about the entire. So probably we need a lot of investigation and more information search about this building type, because it's fairly unique. Both is double walled Avasa case as well as double walled image temple viharas. And also especially the Avasa case are not being used except Vatthepola. All the other three Avasa cases are virtually abandoned and are being used like slow houses, especially the very good example of Karagahagedra is almost in very dilapidated, it's about to come down, the first one that I showed you. So it's difficult to manage that kind of buildings, because unless monks occupy image houses, the archaeology department takes care and try to conserve them, and there are some significance in that. But this kind of image houses, where little attention is paid by the state or by the monks or by the Dharika Sabha, so as they represent an important example, probably we need to pay more attention, especially with respect to the conservation of monk residential buildings, which might be destroyed in a very short period of time. So yes, that's all that what I would say. So, if you have any questions, answer them immediately. Because monk residences are abandoned, because the monks have now constructed new avasas. Ebulo alut korne ke liye hamare dino ewa meethi bora mein ada abu tapu dekhe
with air condition
na oh oh me va air condition na atra me wala kamal bala da ta ma oh ya ta ila tin tan wala kara kaha gedra unath palleha samanya avasaya hadala dinawa eke thamai hamdu පාවිච්චි කරන්නේ. අතම බින්නඩතර මේ චිත්‍ර ළඟයි ළඟදි මම විසර යනකොට තරගාරින් දෙකේ සෑහෙන නවත් පිළක් කැරලා.
ස්ටඩ් ද ටෙම්පල් ඉන් වවුනියා සී දලදා විතර ටෙම්පල්
ඉස්
ඩබල් ලේ වෝල්ස් ඉස් ඉට් බිලොංග් ද සේම් ටයිප් ඇන් ද සේම් කියන ඔව් ඩිෆරන්ට් ටයිප් ඇන් ඩිෆරන්ට් ඊරා
නෑ ඒ ඒ ටෙම්පල් එකේ ආවාස ගේද ඔය කියන්නේ ඉස් ආවාස ගේද
නෝ ඉස් ඉස් Yeah, it's probably
our image house. Is it image house or ours?
It's called our Dalada VR.
Yes, it's image house. Or
image house.
It's a ready clean house.
Double layer wall.
So you have a walkway around it?
Yeah. Not walkway, the wall itself double.
Wall itself is double.
Double.
Right. What is
it?
Maybe to.
That's in Wangia.
Yes, maybe. As a climatic response, one can explain. I think, as I said, we need more investigation. Even at Parthiji, you have this double wall system, but not the double wall gap between the inner chamber and the outer space. Probably due to migrant in that phase, but this also may be migrant. I think you need more investigations.
I think the hypothesis was that the double walls are made for insulation for cooling the building.
Yes,
but is there any possibility that this outer wall was subsequent construction replacing the railing for securing the center core, and that it was not part of the original plan? Now, see, Lanka temple in Kandyan, the outer wall is a subsequent construction, isn't it?
Lanka Tilaka outermost wall, yes, that is the recent construction actually.
Okay.
yes, Lanka later. Now they have added a wall here. Wall here, no? This wall.
And now different to the image house, which was like if you take well and it was covered with a wall here. Well, it's outer.
No, no, I think Lanka there is the original wall.
No, no, no. There's a later construction, taking the 12 posters inside. You have walked inside we had a enter from the Vishnu Devale and go round. You can go like three quarters, not to the main entrance, which has been again is attributed to early Kandyan times, that outer wall.
Yes, but I think because Lankadmika originally had a masonry vaulted roof.
Yes.
You cannot support a roof with columns on the periphery. So the wall would have been originally there.
This is we are talking about the image house.
Image house, yes.
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 Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Because if you look at the Awas case, very unlikely. You cannot have corridor on the periphery and rooms inside. Very unlikely.
Actually, if you look at the most of the temples along the west coast,
yes.
You have got a center core and then you have a veranda, no? And it's then, old. It's all old.
Yes.
You look at even Varame here.
Yes.
If you look at
yes.
Right down to
yes.
Also to
yes.
All that is center core. And then you have a veranda which is more.
Yeah, but the center core is more or less like a living area, no?
No, no, no. We have image houses inside. No?
We are talking about image houses. Ah, image house, yes. Yes. This is inside image houses.
You have that inside.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes.
So the outside got painted, no?
Yes, yes.
Well, just the inside.
Tell about the temple, it was the same.
Even both of me is the same?
Yes.
So yes. Yes. The whole yes. Change was very similar.
Yes.
Also, if I take you back a little more,
yes.
I measured it in 64, possibly yes. Before all by the bomb. At that time, it had 21 courtyard. And the room didn't have any windows.
Yes.
There was a room and it entered a very dark space. Mm. And they were very small, like about 8 by 9 or something like that, or 7 by 6. Very small rooms. Which meant that you just went to sleep, reading books instead of anything else.
Yes.
So it was just had a certain function, only sleep. So I don't know whether, but that falls into it. I'm talking about the old Marmongal,
yes.
Not the later editions and so on. So, it's by Marmongal itself. So long ago, no? So, it's interesting actually.
Are there regulations in the country compelling these temples to maintain? Are there other heritage buildings you have to maintain? You can't do anything like that.
Yes, but
and on the other hand, this is the ministry, monkeys, and then maintain.
Yeah, but the difficulty is. I think as a country we have large number of monuments, unlike some other countries where they have few and then they can concentrate, they can monitor. But because we have large number of monuments, I think the archaeology department, CCEFO, Bukhsasa Ministry, Bukhsasa decided that they pay attention to new ones, they concentrate on the main ones. So, especially the Awasa case does not fall into this very important category. Maybe in which house they will.
They are privately owned.
They are privately owned also. So it is very difficult from here to conserve them or control them. If the monk does not want, it's a simple matter of not repairing the roof, it will fall down. They are not really breaking them. They are not really breaking them.
And personally, something about because privately owned has just made a difference. No, there are not private owned houses, those where you can't demolish, you can't change.
Most of the things are not declared as historic.
Yes.
If we can list out the whole thing and get it declared, all these buildings are more than 100 years old.
Yes.
When it's declared, legally it is protected, even though physically it is not protected.
Yes.
So then we can insist the Department of Archaeology.
Yes, because most of
the
not all.
Image houses are generally
protected.
They are considered protected monuments. Yes, sir. But Bawasan is not.
I have a question. Now, one thing, it was interesting that the two walls concept, but as Ashley said, it is in the south also, and quite old over and quite normal. You don't think it is something special. But on the other hand, in the Sena, we have the real worshipping area with the Buddha statues and with a certain picture program, which is not reflected outside. And I would never call this a veranda, it's an ambulatory. And the terminology from you was quite interchangeable. Veranda, I don't know, architects, how you define it. This is an ambulatory, it can be open also. And on the ambulatory, we have a different picture program altogether. You wouldn't have the ambulatory program inside, like the hills,
yes,
which are later. Second question I want to know, is there any kind of dating from the architect side? Because we have something like 175 Dhammika Viharas now, which you all have sent your students around. Now, is there any kind of dating, morphology, or any kind of classification of this?
You asked the whether these Dhammika Viharas have been dated.
No, dated according the dating is difficult, I know. They have been reconstructed and a lot of things have been added on. But from the constructions create or morphology, is there any kind of effort to stratify and say these can be the early, these can be the middle, or any kind of effort for this?
I think it's in a way difficult because most of these Dhammika Viharas have been modified
all
the time.
Yeah, yeah.
So, when we go to a Dhammika Vihara, it's difficult for us to identify the 15th century construction from the 18th century.
Do you have 15th century Dhammika Viharas?
Yes. If you go to Adigamua, lower level, it's 15th century.
It's later.
It's 15th century. That's the one that I have come across the oldest.
Can't you go back to the core? Because the core generally where the Buddha statue is and where the cella is generally the original section, and you can do any modifications.
Yeah, but then it has also been repainted.
I know,
it's being difficult in a way.
So much damage natural, I mean, if you stay like human, I mean, apart from this building into a British period, a lot of other things when they are old, I mean, you break them up, you have the wall, you fall, the roof will fall, and you die. And I mean, there is a natural, your clothes get old, you outgrow your clothes, and you go on, and you're saying, this is a occasionally, one or two, you can keep it inside. The approach is wrong, this is that decisions. This was never fixed in time, it's fixed in time now only because the period has changed. Like, it was a continuing one, then we have managed to get rid of something which is shifted since.
Yes, I think you are till about 1800. The weather will change and then we get to that.
But that is a natural thing.
No, it's not an unusual situation.
Yes. It's a natural thing.
But what happens now is that the painters are using the modern paints.
Yes.
It has nothing to do with the traditional paint.
Yes.
Plus, we don't have that system now. We are destroying completely by going to universities and so on. We have completely destroyed the parampara, no? So if you look at the 9 days, I mean that the parampara then came, there is one guy left at
it. Down there.
In the archaeology part, young guy. So, I think the future is that we have to now recreate the parampara and let them get back into the temple. Now, maybe what has gone wrong with Nambul is that we have turned the temple into a museum. We should now go and increase the temple. Maybe not like lamps, but Nambul Kogu and all is not too bad.
By referring to these UDA regulations, the possibility of being rejected, the sensitive area of the climate response. Now, let me first off make my observation because in 1978, UDA was created. In 1981, the Lanka Development Plan was gazetted. And the regulations that were made for Kalambo were made applicable for the whole country in 1986. So now we destroyed the identities of the cities were lost and basically is Murali for 6 flats block in Kalambo served with a connected to sewer and water supply. They would reduce the plot size, maybe 2 acres, like Nagapur. But in Kandy, Ruvalini, 6 plus block without water supply or sewage, with 10 foot roadway and sloping hills, it destroyed the entire. Now, similarly, these examples that you showed, you say it's very comfortable. So, whether there is a program to study the comfort levels of the buildings used in the modern day parameters and to help the UDA to formulate regulations for those areas, dry zones, so otherwise they will be applying the same British standard.
I'm glad you mentioned that UDA has destroyed everything, which is true. And now with the megapolis, it will be worse.
Yes.
The solution to this problem is
a megapolis is a real estate exercise.
No, but then where do you go? Where is the garbage going? Where is the storage going? Nobody knows.
I can give an observation.
That is one more question. What is the significance of Maramala? Because you see, how is that almost of temples are around that area?
Where
the closest is Abadiniya kingdom.
Yeah, but these were constructed, the period is after Abadiniya period. We have a probably belongs to Abadiniya. We have a temple, real area, especially the really came on the summit, but we found most of these examples that in that area, especially the Awasakis, monk residences, and also this most of the double wall, Ambit Viharas, Pujapita Electorate, Varyapola, between Varyapola and Nikavaratia, that area. I think we need to explore, that's why I said, we also know Sarmantra Thero also had some connections with that this area, especially Madhyapur temple. As I showed some of the examples from Kalagetra. We are not sure, so we know very little about all of this. Yes. Yes.
Those two temples you showed us, Avasa gave, that's a Kerala DJ.
That one, yes, what the gable end, no?
Yeah,
this one, what you say? This one?
Not the Bihar Kota.
Huh? Bihar Kota. Yeah, yes, this one.
So, lot of the buildings in Kerala have that
feature. Yes.
So, in the 13th century, there are lots of people coming back from Kerala after tourism, coming back into these areas.
Mm.
So, maybe they brought some of those ideas with them. It is a possibility, and I mean, I think that's when the Vishnu part also came to Sri Lanka. That period.
Mm.
So,
I mean, one more reason, like I mean, there were several major cities as well as sub-major cities, no?
Yes.
In and around the Kurunegala.
Yes.
And it had been, I mean, functioned as a society and of Kandy, Kampur, yeah, Kandy period, Kauti period, etc. And even I have presented a paper on Dunpandapula sometime back, Mandik back. So that also is located very close to that area, Nathakan area.
So, Kurunegala was a kingdom, it was the capital of a kingdom.
It was
the
Kampala
was, Kampala
was, Kampala was. Yeah, Kampala, yeah, yeah, Pampala.
These were all capitals, they were coming down to
the apart from that, they have a small societies also, no? Like Mudun Kondapala.
And also one at the Goyen had.
Then
we just want to get us in.
අනුරාධපුර නගරයේ දාන්නේ නගර ප්‍රතිපත්තියේ කෙලිකේක සලසුම් කරන්නේ. ඉතින් එයාගේ සරසම අතරම තමයි අනුරාධපුර නගරය නිර්මාණය කරන්නේ. ඒ කියන්නේ ඒක වී කියන
Yes.